Welcome to the web tutorial, Unit of Analysis in the Main PSID. First, let's go over what you can expect to learn. We will start with a definition of Unit of Analysis, then provide an explanation of the Main study data files, followed by examples of how to structure these data files to study different units of analysis. This tutorial does not address more complex nested units of analysis that require multi-level models. A separate tutorial focuses on Unit of Analysis in PSID supplemental studies. Note that this tutorial assumes basic familiarity with PSID terminology and with the PSID data center. Before proceeding, we recommend viewing two video tutorials, an introduction to the panel study of income dynamics, and accessing and downloading PSID data. Let's begin with an overview of the concept of unit of analysis. PSID data can be analyzed in different ways. You can estimate, for example, the characteristics of family units, of adults heading families, what PSID refers to as reference persons and spouse partners, or of all individuals and families. Starting in 2017, the term reference person has replaced head. This change is not retroactive, however, so when we refer to this individual in a historical context, we still use the term head, or more likely head or reference person. Please see the video tutorial, Introduction to the Panel Study of Income Dynamics, for more information on this change. The unit of analysis is the who or what that you are interested in analyzing, in this case either family units, adults heading families, or individuals. The unit of analysis flows from your research question. If you're studying family income dynamics, the unit of analysis is the family unit. If you are estimating the number of people in poverty, the unit of analysis is the individual. If you are studying health behaviors of adults heading families, the unit of analysis is a subset of individuals, namely heads or reference persons, and spouses or partners. Typically, your analysis file will need to be structured to match your unit of analysis, and the number of observations in your file will therefore depend on the unit of analysis. In this example, there are 4 family units, 6 adults heading families, and 11 individuals. Other units of analysis are possible, but not covered in this tutorial. We mentioned 2 examples here. Although the PSID files are organized at the family and individual levels, a study can also be used to analyze households. In our previous example, 4 family units resided in 3 household units. Users who wish to analyze households may aggregate family units to the household level using the household ID number available in every wave. Because of its genealogical design, it is also possible to analyze pairs of relatives as the unit of analysis. In this example, there are 9 parent-child pairs where both father-child and mother-child relationships are identified as unique. The PSID offers the Family Identification Mapping System tool, or FIMS, to allow automatic linking of parents to children, grandchildren, and great-grandchildren. A separate video tutorial explains FIMS. To create an analytic file for the unit of analysis of interest, you need to have a basic understanding of 3 things. First, the PSID's file structure. For instance, do you need information from the family-level file, the individual-level file, or both? Second, you need to understand for whom the variables of interest have been collected. That is, do you have a variable available about the family unit, for just the adults heading families, for just the respondent to the interview, for all individuals, or for other family unit members? Finally, you need to understand how to restructure the PSID files to create your analytic file with the required unit of analysis. This step may involve merging files, subsetting data, and recoding variables. Let's turn to a description of the structure of the main PSID files and how to tell for whom variables have been collected. From the main interview, the PSID produces 2 files, a family-level file and an individual-level file. The family-level file contains 3 types of information. Information that is collected about the family unit as a whole, information about the adults heading families, and a few variables that are only available for the respondent. These respondent-only variables include psychological variables that measure life satisfaction and psychological distress. These types of questions are not well answered by proxy, so are not asked about the respondent's spouse or partner. The family files are available for each wave of the PSID. The individual level file is a cumulative file that contains information from each wave of the PSID. 2 basic types of variables are available: information collected for all individuals in the family unit, and rarely, information collected for just the adult family members besides the head or reference person and spouse or partner, also known as OFAMs. Next, we will provide 2 examples of how to structure files with different units of analysis. The first example explains how to create a dataset with adults heading families as the unit of analysis for a single year, in this example, 2015. Recall that a majority of detailed information about adults heading families is on the family file. However, your unit of analysis is a subset of individuals, namely the heads or reference persons and spouses or partners. There are four steps. Step 1, create your file. Using the data center, indicate that you would like both family and individual level variables. The data center will automatically merge information from the family file to the individual level file and produce a data set with the individual as the unit of analysis. The file will automatically include the variables relationship to head or reference person and sequence number, which you will need in order to recode variables in the file. Step 2. When you reach the data center checkout page, select the option All Individuals, which will create a file where each individual is an observation. Step 3. After you download your file, you need to subset to adults heading families, specifically individuals who are heads or reference persons, and spouses or partners. To do this, the relationship to head or reference person variable must equal 10, or 20, or 22. Head or reference person, spouse, and partner, respectively. And the value of the sequence number must be in the range of 1 to 20, indicating that they were currently in the family unit in that wave. Step 4. When family and individual level data are merged together, all family level information will be filled in for each individual in that family unit. In this example, that means that each individual will have a value for the head or reference person's smoking status, as well as the spouse or partner's smoking status. Because of this, you will need to create a new set of individual level variables that are assigned to either the head or reference person or spouse partner's information. For instance, an individual's smoking status will be equal to the head or reference person's smoking status if the individual's relationship to head or reference person is 10 and equal to the spouse or partner's smoking status if the individual's relationship to head or reference person is 20 or 22. In rare cases, for instance, if you are planning to analyze one of the few psychological variables collected only from respondents in the main PSID interview, your unit of analysis may be the respondent. This second example explains how to create a dataset with the respondent as the unit of analysis. That is, one observation for each respondent. Step 1. Create your file. Using the data center, indicate that you would like both family and individual level variables. Again, the data center will automatically merge information from the family file to the individual level file and produce a data set with the individual as the unit of analysis. The file will automatically include relationship to head or reference person and sequence number, which you will need in order to recode variables in the file. Be sure to also include from the individual level file the variable who respondent, where a value of 1 identifies if the individual is the respondent in that wave. Step 2. When you reach the data center checkout page, select the option All Individuals. Step 3. After you download your file, you will need to subset to individuals who are respondents. To do this, keep individuals with a value of 1 for who was respondent and a value of 1 to 20 for sequence number. Step 4. Finally, you will need to create a new set of respondent-level variables that are assigned to either the head or reference person or spouse or partner's information. Note that you do not need to create new variables for the variables collected only from respondents. For instance, respondent smoking status will be equal to the head or reference person's smoking status if the respondent's value for relationship to head or reference person is 10, and equal to the spouse or partner's smoking status if the respondent's value for relationship to head or reference person is 20 or 22. The respondent level variables, including life satisfaction and psychological distress, will automatically be correctly assigned to the respondent. This web tutorial was produced by Nora Insalera and Vicky Friedman in collaboration with the Michigan Center on the Demography of Aging, with funding from the National Institute on Aging. This ends the unit of analysis in the main PSID video tutorial. Comments and questions may be sent to psidhelp@umich.edu.